Lagos lawmakers cut short recess to attend to urgent state matters. Lagos Assembly deliberates on a bill for a law to provide for management and protection of the environment. We have details coming up.
A warm welcome to you out there. We're glad to bring you another insightful package on this episode of Lagos Parliament. I am Abimbola Agbibi.
Get closer to your legislators. See them in action as they deliberate on moving the state forward. Watch updates on weekly events, presentation of bills, passage of laws, adoption of resolutions, and many more. Also, get a chance to meet the lawmaker of the week and watch the legislators. Observe plenary in Yoruba language. Lagos Parliament, every Thursday, 7:30 p.m. and Sunday, 11 a.m. respectively, on TVC News Nigeria and TVC Entertainment. Lagos Parliament, bringing the legislators closer to you.
On the 12th of January this year, lawmakers in the Lagos State House of Assembly embarked on a six-week break from plenary activities and were meant to resume on the 28th of February. Now, just 2 weeks into the break, the lawmakers were recalled from their recess to attend to urgent state matters. Many of these lawmakers who spoke to TVC News reiterated the legislature's commitment to put in the needs of the citizenry first.
The lawmakers have been recalled to plenary from the vacation, the annual vacation that we are supposed to be having, because of state matters, urgent and important state matters. There is a particular bill which has been pending our attention before we went on vacation. The bill is the Lagos State Environmental Bill, which is aimed at being a compendium or being a coalition or being a holistic legislation on environmental sanitation matters in Lagos State, from waste collection to waste disposal to waste management.
Apart from our comfort, we are here for a particular cause, and we're committed to representing the good people of Lagos State, and we want to make sure that that in itself is taken into consideration, and which is the ultimate reason why we are representatives in the first place. And we must show good leadership by example, by doing what is supposed to be done, so that when we put it together, the Lagosians as a whole will take it in good faith and implement afterwards.
Our interests should not take preeminence over the interests of the general public that we're serving. We feel we're serving them, and we should be able to serve them conscientiously, and we're there just for a recess to go and have a holiday. And if we were called back to come and serve our people, we should feel honored to come, because they elected us. We have their mandate to go and represent them. They cannot come to the floor to come and legislate. And so we have to make sure that we represent them very well. So that is why we have chosen to come back to do what is expected of us.
As lawmakers in the House of Assembly resumed plenary on the 6th of February, the first task before the lawmakers was the need to work on a bill to harmonize all the laws that affect the state of the environment in the metropolis.
The bill, titled the Lagos State Environmental Management and Protection Law 2016, scaled second reading on the floor of the House shortly after a thorough legislative process. The day's business kicked off with a special focus on a matter that had prior to this day been tagged as urgent. The lawmakers had been recalled from their recess to attend to a bill sent to the House by the executive arm of government. The bill, titled the Environmental Management and Protection Bill 2016, is a 261-section bill expected to serve the following purposes.
This bill seeks to provide for management, protection, and sustainable development of our environment. The bill also seeks to have environmental sanitation corps. These are the people that will enforce the laws and ensure that everywhere in Lagos is clean. The sanitation corps have a lot of responsibility. For the bill also looks at the area of creating a tribunal for resolution of dispute, you will agree with me that when a law is being implemented or there is an enforcement, there are bound to be disputes. And when there's a dispute, you have an opportunity of settling it at our own level using the ADR mechanism rather than, you know, going to court at the first instance.
Some of the lawmakers held varying views on the composition of the bill.
At the same time, when you look at the aspect of the domestic management of the environment that was being stated in this bill, it is being centralized and is taking a lot of work away from the local operators. So which this area too, in solving one problem, it could create another one. That is the operators, the existing operators might be out of work. So, you know, and I think there is need to look into that. The aspect of the fund management, when it comes to the issue of borrowing, where the power is being placed in the hand of the Commissioner for Finance to give approval for borrowing power. So all this one needs to be looked into.
I am an ardent supporter of this bill to the extent that it seeks to create a very clean, safe and healthy environment for us in Lagos State. Let me say that much has been said about by my colleagues. However, I should not fail to mention the fact that there seems to be some contradictions in the bill. For example, if we look at Section 5 of the bill, which talks about revenue collection, and we also look at Section 15 of that same bill, which also talks about billing system, there seems to be some contradiction there which needs to be straightened out and harmonized.
I have one or two reservations. Basically, it has to do with local government. I am a local person, and I believe that whatever is going to happen at the superstructure, it must start from the foundation. If this foundation is shaky, what becomes of the superstructure? If the local governments are not involved, at that level, generation and management of waste is supposed to start with local government.
In the end of the composition of the trust fund, well, I so much agree, but I'm passionate about, in as much as I agree that women gender sensitivity should be taken care of, but saying a committee of six people compelling that minimum of three female should be there is like trying to weaken the men.
Talk on the composition of that minimum of three women. And I'm surprised that our colleagues are even complaining of a minimum of three women out of six, when what we are talking about as women is 50-50 by 2030. And it might be funny when you are a man, but for a woman it's a very serious affair. And I don't see why, when they're talking about a minimum of three women, it becomes an issue to my colleagues, who I believe that we're all forward-looking. And I'm sure Mr. Speaker, who is very gender sensitive and understands that the best practice of the world today is to involve women in those issues.
While they agreed on the advantages of the bill, they found very worrisome a section of the law that seeks to concentrate power on the Commission of the Environment.
The power concentrated on the Commissioner of the Environment is too much. Most especially, we are compressing about 8 laws of the state to one. And we also gave the singular prerogative to the Commissioner to make regulations. This regulation may not come back to the House. And that is the area I felt there are always conflict between the ministry and the House. If it is not assumptuous to say this, that after the regulation made by the ministry, they should make a recourse to the House for us to see whatever regulation that has been passed on.
The fear you have raised, I'm also of concern, most especially in giving enormous power to the commissioner. In fact, for him to oversee about 7 different agencies is a cumbersome exercise, and that will create further problems. So I want to urge the chairman and the members of the committee to look at these areas seriously.
Having talked about the merits and demerits of the bill was thereafter committed to the House Committee on the Environment to report back to them in 1 week. Meanwhile, with the bill committed to the House Committee on the Environment, the chairman of the committee, Honorable Saka Fafumi, shed more light on what Lagos residents should expect from the bill as it concerns the collection, management, and the disposal of waste, among other functions in the state.
You'll agree with me that for a very long time, the issue of environment, we have never at any point attempted to have all the laws, you know, on environment on a single piece of paper. Now, this is a compendium of anything that has to do with environment, as far as Lagos State is concerned, as far as our statute books are concerned. Now, primarily, what we seek to do is to see how we harmonize the law as it affects all agencies under Ministry of Environment. I've seen many efforts that is targeted at, you know, reforming the waste management sector of the state, but I have never seen anyone that is on the scale of what the governor, the proactive governor of the state, Ambode, is proposing on LOMA. The reform is to allow a concessionaire, an investor, or a consortium of investors to take charge of our waste management. Ultimately, the purpose of the bill, the advantages are so enormous. Essentially, the bill will address collection of waste, the domestic waste. For a very long time, we entrusted this in the hands of our PSP, and we've seen what they were able to deliver. And governor is now saying, look, for you to get a different result, you have to do things in a different way.
On a very sad note, you will recall that last week we told you about the death of a former member of the Lagos State House of Assembly, Honorable Mansour Obafemi Durosimi, after a brief illness. Members of the House of Assembly spared a thought for him during their plenary on Monday, the 6th of February.
Distinguished honorable members,
it's with a deep sense of loss and regret that I rise this afternoon to inform you, sir, officially, and distinguished colleagues, that on the 38th day of January 2017, a very dark cloud enveloped the political climate of Koshofe local government area, especially Koshofe constituency 2. Sir Speaker, my predecessors in office, my illustrious predecessor in office, Honorable Mansour Obafemi Durosimi, who represented Koshofe 2 constituency in this August Assembly from 1999 to 2007. When he was here as member, while he held sway as member in this Assembly, he was chairman House Committee on Sports in 1999 to 2003. He later became the chairman of House Services 2003 to 2007, and he delivered well on his assignments when he was here, sir. So on that note, that I want to appeal and urge the Honorable House to kindly sympathize with us, the good people of Agboike too, especially, and to see ways in which we can commiserate with his immediate and extended families. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
What can I say about Honorable?